Teachers and students groups in the Philippines repeat their call for additional funds and manpower to ensure a safe return to classrooms. We have more on that from our correspondent Anjo Bagawisan. Anjo.
Good afternoon, Stanley. With the Philippine government now mandating a full return to face-to-face classes by November of this year, various groups are seeking measures to ease concerns on the safety of students. The Alliance of Concerned Teachers, or ACT, calls for the hiring of 100,000 more public school teachers. ACT and the Teachers Dignity Coalition also asking for funding to build additional classrooms and help schools prepare for the return to on-site learning. TDC is still calling for the opening of classes to be moved to September, while ACT is waiting for the DepEd or the Department of Education to release an order on the proportional vacation leave or break of teachers to determine when schools could start. The Philippines remains among the last countries to implement face-to-face learning. A group of students say many students already look forward to returning to schools as soon as possible, but they hope preparations are enough to ensure they will be safe. The National Union of Students of the Philippines says additional funding would be needed for regular testing, contact tracing, and free treatment should infections come. The National Parent Teachers Association of the Philippines, meanwhile, says 3 in 10 parents are still opposed to returning to face-to-face classes in November due to concerns over lack of preparation and high commuting fares. Stanley, back to you.
Okay, thanks a lot for the update, Andrew Bagawisan. On to more news. Various groups have gathered in Quezon City to lay down what they want to hear from President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s first State of the Nation address. Our correspondent Johnson Manabat is on the line for details. Johnson, good afternoon. What can you tell us?
Yes, Stanley, good afternoon. We just more than a week before the first State of the Nation address, or SONA, of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., multi-sectoral groups are gearing up for their activities on July 25th. This morning, Ting Tang Ibon Foundation, together with progressive groups Bayan, Makabayan Coalition, and the Movement for Governance and Genuine Democracy in cooperation with other groups such as Cure COVID, Rise Up and Contra Daya held a People's Summit in Quezon City. They laid down some of their demands under the Marcos administration, hoping to find ways to achieve this amid a pandemic brought about by COVID-19. The People's Summit hopes that this administration will address issues of rising prices of basic services and commodities by suspending taxes on oil products, supporting a national minimum wage, and by providing adequate aid for the economically displaced during the pandemic. They are also calling on the Marcos administration to revive local agriculture and make domestic food production a top priority by suspending conversion of agricultural lands and provide 15,000 peso subsidy for Filipino farmers and fisher folk. The group is hoping for a more comprehensive and free healthcare programs and basic social services for the people by realigning funds from the build infrastructure projects, work bravo spending, militarization campaigns, and other non-productive, wasteful expenditure items towards health, education, housing, and economic aid for the people. They're also challenging the Marcos administration to uphold national sovereignty and an independent foreign policy. This administration, according to them, should also ensure environmental protection, rehabilitation, and balanced use of the country's natural wealth. Another cluster of this group promised to continue fighting for their constitutional rights to press freedom and freedom of expression. Renato Reyes, Secretary General of Bagong Alyansang Makabayan, said they already sent a letter to the office of Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte yesterday about their intention to conduct protest rally along Batasan Road near the Batasang Pambansa on July 25th. Stanley.
All right. Thanks a lot for the update, Johnson Manabat.